So you're sitting around thinking about your event and you realize during cocktail hour, you have nothing for the kids to do. Today, we're going to discuss the use of vendors, when to use them, why you should, here on Check 1-2 TV.
Roll tonight I'm going to be your favorite DJ, favorite DJ, favorite DJ.
Thank you for tuning in to Check 1-2 TV. Here on this channel, we discuss all things related to your event. That could mean DJs, venues, vendors, lighting, all the things that make your party amazing. Today, we're going to be discussing the use of vendors. Everybody's a vendor, but cocktail hour vendors are very specific. Those are the people you hire to entertain your kids for an hour to 2 hours or 3 hours, depending on how long you book them. They range from very simple things to very extravagant things. On the basic level, you have photo booths, airbrush tattoo artists, airbrush clothing artists, wax hands, caricature artist, just things to keep the kids busy, because that's really what it's designed for. It's designed to make sure the kids are focused during that time on something besides breaking everything at the venue. So as the kids get there, they have something to do. The kids only eat for so long, and then they're like, okay, what do we do now? That's what the vendors are for. I get a lot of questions from clients about what types of vendors should they get. Today I'm going to try to answer the top five questions that clients ask about vendors. So let's start with question one. Are vendors necessary? That answer is difficult because they're not mandatory. You don't need them to have a successful party, but they do help. Vendors keep kids busy, they keep them entertained, they allow the adults to kind of operate on their own without having to worry about what the kids are doing. So I would say, yes, they're important, but no, they're not mandatory. Question two. How many vendors do I need? Well, typically speaking, it's based upon the amount of people you have. So if you have 1 to 130 people, I would say you need no more than 2 or 3 vendors at most. It depends on the vendor. It depends on what they're doing. Question three. How long do I need my vendors for? This is the $1 million question and one that I try to make people understand. Vendors are supposed to be designed for cocktail hour, then they extend into the event for a little bit of time, because once the DJ gets them, we want all the focus on us. We want the kids to be focused on us. We want the adults, everybody dancing to us. Because when you hire a DJ, it's under the understanding that they're gonna get these people dancing. The less things you have, the less distractions you have, the more focused your guests will be on the DJ and on dancing. Did I answer the question? So typically speaking, you need a vendor for 2 to 3 hours. Typically a vendor will require you to have at least a minimum of 2 or 3 hours just to get them booked there. That's pretty normal. I would never say you need a vendor at your event for the entire night. 2 to 3 hours is great. So if you do the math, you have 1 hour of cocktail, then cocktail ends and they're there for another 2 hours. The first half hour to 45 minutes is opening dance set, it's speeches, it's all the little things. And then after that, you're gonna eat. So then you have another hour that the people can hit the vendors. There's a couple of vendors that are great no matter what. One of those vendors is like a photo booth. A photo booth is easy because the photo booth can be moved from outside to inside and they don't get in the way. People, as they're dancing, can look over and see that there's a photo booth and it's open. They'll go over there to the photo booth and then they're gonna come right back and dance. That's what we want. We want to avoid creating lines. Question four. Which ones should you get? This is a very subjective thing because people like different things. Some people are gonna want a photo booth and a henna artist. Other people are gonna want airbrush clothing guy and a basketball pop shot. It's completely subjective. It's not something that I can really tell you what to do. But what I will tell you is things to avoid, which comes to my next question. Question number five. What types of vendors should I avoid? Well, first I'm gonna give you a factual and then I'm gonna give you a personal. Factual is there's nothing wrong with any vendors out there. Vendors are there to do a job. And if you've hired that vendor, it's because you've liked that vendor and that's great. However, certain vendors create issues and it's not their fault. It's just the nature of what they do. So let's talk about some, for example. The wax hand guy is great. They dip their hands in the wax, it solidifies, now they have a wax hand that they can take home with them. That's great. The issue with the wax hand guy is, and it's not just his issue, it's the issue with the wax hand guy, the tattoo artist, the caricature artist. First off, there's a very specific amount of available spots at one time, which means you're creating lines for people to wait in. Now, lines during cocktail hour, lines are fine. During a party, lines kill a party. They literally will take everybody away from your dance floor because they're not gonna wanna leave the line because they're gonna lose their spot. So people like the wax hand guy, it's fantastic, but he creates a lot of lines because people have to put their hand in and then they have to just sit and wait for it to harden. The other thing about the wax hands are, some of them, not all of them, will give the kids the wax hands during the party, and then naturally these kids are gonna take the wax hands out, they're gonna break them, they're gonna throw them, you're gonna have wax all over the floor, wax everywhere, and that is a mess that you don't wanna deal with. Not to mention any type of cleanup fee that they're gonna charge you for these wax hands. So if you're gonna get the wax hands, make sure they hold the wax hands until the end of the night and they can treat it like a goodie bag for the kids as they leave the room. Things like airbrush hats, airbrush clothing, those are fantastic too. All the kids put their orders in during cocktail hour, and then after that, they spend the rest of their night filling the orders. That's the best possible vendor to get. They're easy. Again, the kids take everything home like goodie bags. Sometimes when they're done with them, they give them to the kids throughout the party. Now the kids have a really cool jacket or a hat that they're wearing through the party. So that's fantastic. Those are the things that we actually like. So let me just put a disclaimer, because I mentioned the facts. Now I'm going to mention the personal. First off, I don't want anyone to not work. Everybody deserves a right to work. I'm not telling you what to do with your event. I'm just telling you the things that I observe from these vendors. So if you decide to hire a basketball pop a shot, a air hockey table, a video game center, all of these things are pretty much a no-go in dance-oriented events. If you want your people to dance, those things you should avoid like the plague. Here's the reason why. First off, let's talk about the air hockey. Air hockey is a cool game. You can only play two at a time. So two at a time means people are standing around waiting. There are going to be kids that don't leave that hockey table for the entire night. So you want to avoid that. The basketball pop-a shot is probably the most controversial vendor that you can bring in. The reason being is that clients assume, well, this is great. The kids love basketball, they're sports kids, they're gonna love these things. And this is true, they do love it. They love it so much that they don't wanna leave it. They love it so much that they want to emulate their favorite basketball player. So it starts out as the kids shooting right in front of the game, ends with kids believing there's Steph Curry shooting 30 to 45 footers from within your ballroom. Here's an example. You see where the pop-a shot is. You see in relation to the room where it is. Now look where the kids are shooting the balls from. See how far back they're shooting it? And unless we stop them from shooting them, they will continue to go back farther and farther until they break something. One of the rules we tell people that if you decide that you want to have this, your kid really wants the pop-a shot, fine. Allow us at certain times of the night to shut down the vendor. Allow us at certain times of the night to remove the balls so they don't become a distraction. And I don't even mean shut down for the night. I mean, we're doing opening dance set and we need everybody to focus on us. We're gonna tell your vendors, shut down for 25 minutes while we do the grand entrance and the horror and the wedding first dance and whatever else we're trying to do. We'll tell the vendors that. Most vendors are understanding and they're gonna shut down. Other vendors, So my final statement would be, think about what kind of party you want. If you feel that your kids need all of these vendors in order to have a successful party, that's fine, but just realize it's going to limit the amount of people, the amount of energy on the dance floor. So just know what kind of party you want. We're capable of doing them all, but just think about what's important to you before you hire all the vendors. Less is more. The less vendors you have, the more focused your guest will be on the DJ, which is why you hire us. Thank you guys for checking out the videos. If you have any questions about what I talked about, just leave your comment below. I'll try to answer them as quickly as possible. And don't forget to subscribe. I update these things weekly with more tips and tricks on how you can have better parties. Once again, thank you guys for checking out Check 1 2 TV. Have a great day. We'll see you next time. Peace.
Let's go! When I say check 1, 2. Oh. When I say check 1, 2. Oh. When I say check 1, 2. Oh. When I say check 1, 2. Oh.